First of all, what exactly is DVT?
So Lauren, let's start with the basics. So let's talk about what an artery and a vein is. So arteries are the blood vessels that bring the blood down into the legs, and veins are the blood vessels that bring the blood out of the legs. So what happens in DVT is that a blood clot builds up in the veins, prohibiting the blood from flowing out of the legs.
Okay, and are there any similarities between DVT and PAD, or are we talking about a completely different situation here?
They're very, very different, in fact. So one is caused by atherosclerosis, and the other is caused by blood that isn't flowing. And so while many patients with PAD get DVT and vice versa, they're really caused by different things. There's really a different set of risk factors. But the reason we lump them together is because they both affect the legs, and they both, you can have leg pain with both of these. And one of our jobs as doctors, when you come in, is to figure out whether this is arterial or venous, because patients obviously, and you yourself in the audience, may not be able to figure that out. So that's our job.
That's why we're glad we have you, so you can kind of tell us what obviously is going on. So we actually have a list of some conditions that can be related to DVT. You mentioned there are some others, and doctors, we have them here. We're talking about varicose veins, arterial disease, inflammatory bowel disease, cancer, heart failure, heart attack, and spinal cord injuries and paralysis. Now, to me, again, this is kind of a wide range of conditions, and I'm just wondering, is if you have any of those in particular, does it put you at greater risk for DVT, or is it just all of them in general?
You know, that's a pretty comprehensive list. Each of those puts you at risk. But two of the biggest things weren't really on that list, and that is prolonged immobility, so people who take long plane flights, transcontinental plane flights, or if you're sick and you're in the hospital and you're laying around for 5 days or 7 days or even 3 days. And then the final thing, many of the things that were on that list, you say, well, I'm young and healthy, that doesn't affect me. Well, for women in particular, taking birth control pills can predispose you to DVT. So even young, healthy people that take long flights or young women on birth control pills can have this problem. So it can affect all ages, all ranges of people.